Eric Thomas is an author, motivational speaker, and minister whose work has impacted tens of millions of people around the world. He went from dropping out of school, being homeless, and eating out of garbage cans to being one of the most successful and highest paid speakers on the planet. Need motivation?
Watch a top 10 with Believe Nation.
Top 10, top 10, I got a top 10, 10, top 10. Got my motivation high for my top 10. Gotta learn from the wise women and men.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and I make these videos because you are most likely the most ambitious person that you know, but you're capable of doing a lot more, and you get that push by surrounding yourself with the best. So today, let's learn from one of the best, Eric Thomas, and my take on his top 10 rules to success. Enjoy. Okay, let's kick it off with rule number one, take responsibility.
I think what happened when I was homeless, it was a beautiful awakening. It's like when you're living in your parents' home, they are the enemy. You know, everything you don't do right is because of them. And then when you're on your own and you had a say, you start making mistakes that you made when you were at home, it's like you can't put it on mama now. Mama not with you no more. You can't put it on daddy and say, my father was too hard. I had a curfew. You know what I'm saying? They wouldn't let me party past 12. Like I had all these excuses why I wasn't successful because of my parents. But then I was homeless and still messing up in school. You know what I'm saying? I was homeless and still getting pulled over by police. You know what I'm saying? For my boy selling dope. Like, I was still getting shot at. Like, it was some crazy stuff happening in my life. And I was like, yo, Eric, you finally have what you always wanted, control over your life, and you're getting the same results. So it's only one common denominator. The teacher doesn't know the cop that arrested you. The cop don't know your mama. You know what I'm saying? The cop don't know the principal. But one of these kids, everybody knows. The cop knows you, the teachers know you, the counselor know you, your mama know you, the police know you. You are the most common denominator in all of this mess. So because there's one person that's in all of this, that one person is the problem. And I begin to say to myself, like, yo, E, if you really want to change, you have to take personal responsibility. And I think the company is where it is, and people follow me because they don't hear a bunch of excuses. They hear, yo, E, you coming at me hard, but it's the truth. Like, I know what I'm doing wrong, and I just need to make the adjustment. So I would say personal accountability and personal responsibility is what took me from being homeless and a high school dropout to the number one motivational speaker in the world.
Rule number two, be the best version of yourself.
We live in a society where some among us are prejudiced, right? So there are people who would not traditionally hire Eric Thomas. But you will get to a point where nobody else can do what I do. And your company, the value of your company is greater than your racism. Hear what I'm telling you. So you may be racist and not want to hire an African-American male that looks like me, but because I'm the best version of myself in terms of what I do online, I can compete with anybody else who's doing it. The PhD, right? I need you to hear what he's saying. The PhD was very intentional and deliberate, living a life of character. These are all things that's going to help me out. And then my relationship with God, you through now. There's nothing you can do. You stuck now. You stuck. So it's like you call everybody else. You might even brought them in and it didn't change anything. So now you're like, all right, last resort, I got to bring ET in. And then I come in with the anointing and rip shot. And then you like, can we get the retainer? I'm like, you could have started with me, right? So I'm telling you what he's telling me is the truth. I'm not saying, oh, I can't believe there's still racist people in 2019. That has nothing to do with me. That's not my fight. My fight is being the best version of Eric Thomas. That's what I can control. I can't control industries. I can't control what people think or say, but what I can control is Eric Thomas. And so I'm telling you what he's saying is real. Because you're like, but I gotta. No, you don't. You don't. You still in your mind when he was saying it. It was like, but you don't get it. I gotta. And they don't. No. You just need to get to that place where you are strong. And when you go in, you on some Jedi mind trick stuff.
Rule number three, stop complaining.
They like, you entertainment seeking.
E, did you see Power? Absolutely not. Did you see the Game of Thrones? Absolutely not. I'm trying to blow up. I'm trying to blow up after the blow up. I'm number one. Now I'm trying to find out what's after number one. And you know what that is? That's not a speaker. That's a businessman. So I'm trying to own as many companies as I can, get as much equity as I possibly can. I don't got time for the Game of Thrones. I'm playing my own games. I'm trying to sit on a throne. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get a throne. I'm just saying, for real, some of you broke and you still entertained. Like, I'm not even tripping on those of you who got money and you comfortable and you want to chill and watch it. I'm talking about those of you who are complaining about your job. You ain't got no money and you sitting here complaining about, but then you watching all the TV programs. That's a have-not mentality. The rich person made Game of Thrones. They don't even watch it like you watch it. They can't even enjoy it. They put that Joker together. They watching it like, that didn't come right. Oh, Lord, she didn't say it right. They were awful. Oh, man, okay, next episode. You sitting there in a house that you can't even afford. You in your mama's basement watching Game of Thrones. You just comfortable. I just need to come out right now. See, give me a device on the next one. We could just start hitting folks in the face. Just blah. I need to bring you to your senses. You in your mama's basement watching TV. All right. Pleasure before payment. For real, you like to get, you do things that you can't afford. For real, you do stuff you can't afford. And then you don't understand that this society is built rich off of people who like pleasure before payment. They making money off of you because you buy a car you can't afford and they charge you 5-6 times more for it. They give you a house that you can't afford and you thought it was $300,000, but come to find out when you finish paying for it 15, 30 years later, that house wasn't $100,000. Now it's about $700,000. You didn't pay the extra $500,000 for a house. That's not worth it. But they caught you because you was broke.
Rule number 4, write down your ideas.
It only takes one good idea, right, to become a multimillionaire, to become a billionaire, all right? Yeah, you feel me? One idea. Here's a challenge, though. Some of y'all have like 6 or 7 of them a week and you don't write them down. I'm just being real. Like, and here's what, this is what hurts me. Some of y'all, you look at the left and you look to the right to be successful when you need to look within. Like, for real, you were born with a gift. You were born great, guys. And you got to start looking within, not without.
Also, if you want to have more confidence and motivation, check out my 254 series, where every day for the next 254 days, I will send you an email with a link to an unlisted video to help you build more confidence. The link to join for free is down below in the description.
You got to make a sacrifice. If you're going to get to the next level, you're going to have to give up something. There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse.
Freshman year in college, me and my boys start like this, like Christian, like organizations.
Rule number 5, observe where to serve.
Just find somewhere to serve and serve. Or if you can't find nowhere to serve, sit your butt down and observe. Sit down and observe. Observe where you can serve. Right? So don't do all that talking. Don't be running your mouth. Just sit down somewhere. They know you there. They invited you. So sit down and go, okay, where can I serve? So I was like, all right, Tony, I got you. And I knew what he said. Can I be real? It stung a little bit. It did. It stung a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But I was encouraged because I knew what to do the next time. And so the next time I was with the big boys, I act like I belong there.
Rule number 6, have discipline.
Listen to me very closely. A lot of you could be millionaires, but because you're not disciplined, he pulls on a couple. Some of you, because you're not sexually disciplined, you've had people take stuff from you and you've been in places and relate. I just saw 2 young women that lost their lives that was on some dating thing and went to some man. I was just like, yo, where they do that at? Where do you just trust somebody online that you don't even know? What was it about you that you were had such a low self-esteem and then was twins, it was sisters, that you just gonna go to some man house you don't even know? Come on. Then another young lady just went to jail. Her man told her he killed somebody and she took a saw and saw. I'm like, boo, you about to go to jail? I'm like, wow, is it that love that deep these days? People buying stuff. I'm like, well, you ain't grateful for what God, you got to get the extra hookups? I ain't mad at you, but if you do that, you understand what you attracting. And then you mad when you ain't attracting a successful man of character and integrity and God, but you not putting that out. Okay, I'm sorry. All right. Listen to me very closely. Somebody, your zero is going to go to the next level when you can learn to say no. I was just at a function. My man was like, E, you did a phenomenal job, bruh. We doing happy hour at 3:30. I said, my plane leave at 3:50. He said, you're not going to stay for happy hour? I said, bruh, I'm not here for no happy. We don't know each other like that. Happy hour? I came to speak. I didn't come to build no relationship with you. I didn't come to drink with you. Drink? Bro, I don't even drink. And if I drank, I would drink at home. I wouldn't drink in front of you and get loose like that and start talking crazy. You don't need to know me like that. You need to know me as the number one motivational speaker in the world. Flawless. I'm not, but that's what you need to know me as. You don't even need to get close enough to me to know my faults. This is a business transaction. You going doing business with people drinking. Like, y'all, what you being social for? You don't have no discipline. Drink when you get home. You just see some free wine. You see some free alcohol. Drink when you get home. This is business. Boundaries. There are boundaries. My man like, yo, why you got to go? Because I'm married. I got a wife. I'm going home. We finished. We ain't got no more business to do. You told me you wanted a two-hour presentation. I did it. I'm going home. But E, this is a resort. And I'm going home. Why? Because I can't get in trouble at home. I can't get in trouble at the crib. I can get in trouble at this resort. It's a lot of temptation at this resort. So I'm going home.
Rule number 7, get it out of your system.
I went to a whole nother level of my life when I finally confronted. When I say confronted, I don't mean in a negative way. I just meant when I got past my fear of talking to my biological father, because I never talked to him. So I remember thinking that I'm going to meet him and we need to be able to do boom, 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 boom in order for me to heal. But all I needed to do was to get it out of my system. And once I got out of my system, I no longer needed like a regular comp, like I didn't need him to do anything to heal me. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So sometimes you just need to get that information, like you're frustrated because they're not listening and nobody's on your value system. This is why this is important. You're not just coming to hear ET. You are coming to meet your brothers and sisters. You're coming to meet the people that have the same values that you have. That's the problem back at work. You don't have enough people who are where you are, and it's frustrating going to a job where people don't think like you. And so it's frustrating. So all you need to be able to do is get it out with these people and your family. What they're going to do for you is they're going to tell you the right thing. But a half of it is just getting out your chest. And once you get the frustration out, you're going to be able to go in the other day. Next time you go in, you're not even going to see them. They're invisible.
Rule number 8, leave the past in the past.
For those of you who know, you know that you are making excuses, that you blaming other people, that you are afraid, that you walk in fear, you walk in guilt, something that happened, you had an abortion 5 years ago, you still own that. 10 years ago, you had an abortion, you still own that. You got caught, you went to jail, you have a felony, you still own that. I want to free you. That was 5 years ago, why are you still walking in that? That was 10 years ago, you got a divorce. That your mom went to the grave. And she was not proud of you. She would be proud now. Walk in it. Your past is the past. And there's nothing you can do about it. I am ashamed of some of the stuff I did to my mom. Ashamed of some of the stuff I did in school. Ashamed, but it's over. And you can't hold that against me. And I will not hold it against myself. I'm free. I'm free. And whom the Son has set free, he's free indeed. She is free indeed. You've been holding your blessings up because of your past. You feel bad about it. You were wrong when you did it, but it's over. Cleanse yourself. Cleanse yourself. You've already been forgiven. Accept it. And now let's walk in it. The dream is yours, but you're saying, I'm not worthy of the dream. You're probably not, but it's been given to you anyway.
I'm not smart enough. You're probably not. But it doesn't matter. It was given to you, and is now your responsibility to do something with it. You've been given it. It's the gift that you never opened. It's the gift. It's yours. So I need you to forgive yourself.
Rule number 9, set your goals.
There should never be a week in your life that you're just going through the motions. Like every single week, there should be something specific that you're trying to accomplish. All right? And then there should be something monthly that you're trying to accomplish. All right? Every single minute of the day, we should be unleashing our gift on somebody. Somebody getting it. I know we're going to talk about this in a minute, but I know what my superpower is. And CJ calls it a superpower. I know what my superpower is. So when I get in the elevator with you, you may not speak, but I'm speaking. Why? Because that's my superpower. All right? Somebody like, E, why are you speaking to them and they're not speaking to you? I don't live my life based on what other people do. I live my life based on my superpower. So when I speak to people, people are my superpower. So if there's another human in the building, you getting it, all right? So I wake up every morning, I'm going to unleash my gift, but then I have to have a goal, because if I'm not careful, I'm just unleashing my gift without a goal. It's not going nowhere. And so I have to give my goal, my gift, I have to give it a sense of purpose, a sense of order, a sense of direction, right? So every day when you get up, you're weak to have a direction, that this is what you're seeking to get done in that week. This is how much money you should make. Oh, come on, somebody. Look, the reason why the $100,000 a week didn't come to you, because you didn't assign it to come to you. You didn't assign it. So you just randomly hoping it's gonna come. Now you have to assign it. You have to tell it which bank account it's going to. Oh, come on, somebody. You don't go to the bank and just give them $100,000. They want to know, is it your savings? Is this going into your check-ins? Is this the joint boy, right? So every day, every week, every month, every quarter, every year, you should have a destination for your time, for your money, for your relationships.
And rule number 10, the last one before a very special bonus clip, is don't run from challenges.
You run from challenges, and what you don't realize, you've heard me say this before, a diamond isn't a diamond because it don't go through nothing. You feel me? Like, the diamond is a diamond because of the process, yeah. Right? And we know the first is the pressure that it has to go through. And I'm telling y'all, if there's one thing I want y'all to tell the millennials, they got the relationship that they have with pressure is weird. I promise you, it's the weirdest thing I've ever seen. With millennials, they trying to run from problems. Like, for real, like, about to commit suicide because of pressure, right? And they'll come to me, these millennials will come to me like, yo, E, I'm going through it. I'm like, you not, like, I got a lot on my plate. You ain't picking cotton. You ain't got those kind of problems. I'm just being real. Like, this ain't civil rights. You don't have dogs coming at you. I'm just being real. No dogs are coming at you. You don't have water hoses. You don't have people with clubs beating you upside your head. You ain't got no real problems. Like, you ain't got no real problems, right? So for me, I understand that when I look at my ancestors, like, challenges and pressure is why we say Martin Luther King, because he went through them. It's why we say Malcolm X, because we say Rosa Parks or Harriet Tubman. Why? Because of the challenges that they went through and they got through it. So listen to me. The first part of a diamond is pressure. The pressure is what destroys all the dross, like all the unnecessary stuff about you. Pressure is going to get that stuff out the way and bring greatness out of you.
Now, I've got a special bonus clip from Eric that I think you're going to enjoy. But before that, if you're still here watching this video, I want you to make a commitment to yourself that you will not just watch this video, but take some immediate action after watching it. That's what we do here in Believe Nation. So if that's you, give me a hashtag Believe down in the comments below, because I want to celebrate you.
One group, they parasites. So they take it from her and they're not giving nothing back to her. Right? So I don't even, look, you said she didn't say that. She did, because I know humans. I know human beings, right? So if you're giving, you have one group of people who take from you and they give nothing back. That's the group y'all got to stay far away from. You got to grow up, and you got to remove them. I don't know what it is, how you grew up. You just feel like you got to look out for people that ain't looking out for you. What happens with parasites, if they keep taking, they call your bank account. You did what with your bank account when you keep taking and you can't overdraft? And what do they do to your bank account? They close it. Know what I'm saying? That's the same thing happening in your life. You're just not getting it. So people keep taking, and they're going to overdraft your joint, and then a part of your life is going to close. Right? Which means that you won't be getting blessings in that area. It won't flow. Right? So we got parasites. Then we got commensalism. That's the group that we give to. They're not bad people. They don't take, but they don't do nothing. That's the worst group. They just neutral. They don't do nothing. They have absolutely nothing to give you. Now, they're not bad people. They don't mess nothing up. They just don't do nothing. They just like your car just in neutral the whole time. It's terrible. It's wasted energy, wasted gas. It's just a waste. What you want is mutualism. You want those relationships that when you pour, you get fed.
If you want 10 more fire rules from Eric Thomas, check out the video right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.
Your problem is you fishing on the left side. I don't even know who told you to fish over there in the first doggone place, but do me a huge favor. Just make a shift.